Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the last lecture, we saw that systems of linear equations can be used to calculate shapes which are not linear, such as the equation for a parabolic trajectory. In this lecture, we will use a system of three linear equations and three variables to calculate a different kind of nonlinear shape. In the pre-algebra lecture, The Dawn of Numbers, we saw how the inhabitants of Coco Loco Island were introduced by the Bongo Ponganians to the base 10 number system. From that time on, the mathematical skills of the Coco Loconians developed at a rapid pace. One day, the king of Coco Loco decreed that the day the Coco Loconians and the Bongo Ponganians first met be declared a national holiday, and that a monument be erected in honor of that historic event. The monument was to be located in the center of a circular amphitheater, and the amphitheater was to be of proper size and location so that its perimeter just touches the three sacred coconut palms of Coco Loco. Unfortunately, none of the king's royal architects could figure out exactly where to place the center of the circle and how large to make its radius so that its perimeter would exactly touch all three sacred palms. So the king sent out his messengers to every corner of the island to find anyone who could solve this problem mathematically. At long last, the most brilliant mathematician on Coco Loco stepped forward. He told the king that he could solve the problem using a system of three linear equations and three variables. The king and his architects were amazed. They knew that if an equation giving the radius and center point of the circle could be determined, that they would know exactly where and how large to make the amphitheater. They also knew that the general equation for a circle in Cartesian coordinates is x squared plus y squared plus cx plus dy plus e equals 0, where c, d, and e are numbers which determine the size and position of the circle. But how could a system of linear equations be used to determine the nonlinear formula for a circle? No problemo, said the mathematician. I will show you how this can be easily done. We will start by choosing a coordinate system. We can use x to represent distance in Coco Loconian units from the origin in the east-west direction, and y to represent distance in the north-south direction. We will then pick some point in the vicinity of the arena to be the origin. The x and y coordinates of an object will represent that object's distance east and north of that point. Measuring the locations of each sacred palm tree, we find that their x and y coordinates are 9, 2, 10, 3, and 10, 9. All we must do now is determine the equation for the circle which passes through all three points. We start with the general equation of a circle. Since the circle must include each point, the x and y coordinates of each point must satisfy this equation. Therefore, if we replace x and y in the equation with the x and y coordinates of any one of these points, the equation will be a true statement. If we do this for each of the three points, we will create three true statements. This gives us a system of three linear equations and three variables, C, D, and E. The next step is to write these equations in standard form. We first complete the arithmetic, and move the numerical constants to the right side. We then write each term so that the numerical coefficient is in front of the variable. We can now solve this system to find the values of the variables C, D, and E. We will start by eliminating the variable E using the first and second equations. Multiplying the bottom equation by -1 and adding the equations, we get 6D equals -72, or dividing by 6, D equals -12. Now we will eliminate E using the second and third equations. Multiplying the bottom equation by -1 and adding the equations, we get C plus D equals -24. The value of C can now be found by substituting -12 for D in the bottom equation. The values for C and D can now be substituted into any of the original equations to find the value of the remaining variable, E. Since the bottom equation has the smallest coefficients, we will use it to find the value of E. Substituting the values for C and D into this equation, and completing the arithmetic, we get -132 plus E equals -85. And adding 132 to both sides, gives us E equals 47. So the values of C, D, and E are -12, -12, and 47. Substituting these values for C, D, and E into the general equation for a circle, and plotting the graph of this equation, we can see that this circle includes each of the three points. We also find that the center of this circle is located 6 units east and 6 units north of the origin, and that the radius of the circle is 5 units. Given this information, the Coca-Laconians were able to build the monument and amphitheater exactly as the king had decreed, touching each of the 3 sacred coconut palms of Coca-Loco. And the mathematician became quite the celebrity on Coca-Loco Island. As advanced as the Coca-Laconians were mathematically, they had not yet discovered that it was not necessary to physically plot the equation for a circle in order to determine its radius and the coordinates of its center point. In a future algebra lecture, we will see that the general equation for a circle can be rewritten in what is called standard or center radius form, where the constant r is the radius of a circle, and the constants h and k are the coordinates of the center point. In the last several lectures, we have seen that systems of equations with more than 2 variables can be very useful in modeling real-world problems. However, as the number of variables and equations increases, systems of equations can become much more difficult to solve. As a result, mathematicians have devised methods of solving systems of equations using matrices and a series of basic steps which can be performed on these matrices regardless of the number of equations and variables in the system. In the next lecture, we will introduce matrices and the mathematical operations used to solve systems of linear equations using matrices.